And now our next speaker is going to be Dr. Jerome Konecsni, and he's currently the CEO of Innovation Saskatchewan. And the title of his presentation is going to be Developing Your Innovation Toolbox. Dr. Konecsni is an award-winning innovator and has been part of teams that have received national awards in innovation and science. As Director General at the National Research Council, he was a member of the team that was awarded the National Public Service Award of Excellence for their contribution to science, which was the first 100% biojet flight in the world. As Vice President of Bioregional Food and Science, he was a member of the team that received the National Research Council's Innovative Product Award for significant accomplishments in the area of lipid biosynthesis. Sorry, Jerome, I don't know what that is. Before joining Innovation Saskatchewan as CEO in October 2011, he served as Director General of the National Research Council's Plant Biotechnology Institute in Saskatoon. Dr. Konecsni also brings an entrepreneurial background from prior positions as the President and CEO of both Genome Prairie and Biosmart Technologies, and as Vice President of Corporate Development at Bioregional Food and Science. He has extensive international experience and has managed and facilitated many international research projects. Dr. Konecsni was born in Saskatchewan, received his education at the University of Saskatchewan, and was recently awarded a doctorate from Karunia University in India. Jerome, the stage is yours.
Thanks, Curtis. Thank you very much, Curtis. First of all, I'd like to wear my Innovation Saskatchewan hat and representative of the province of Saskatchewan and just say that Innovation Saskatchewan is very pleased to be working with the Chamber of Commerce on this important conference. I think it's absolutely critical. The more study, the more reading you do, you understand how important productivity gains and competitiveness are to Saskatchewan industries, and perhaps a loom is one of our greatest threats. So these kinds of efforts are very important, and we've heard from some excellent speakers today. That'll give us a lot of food for thought and hopefully take some of these things back and implement them. I also want to acknowledge our representatives from Innovation Saskatchewan who helped work with Curtis and Steve and the team. Ron Kreiza is Innovation Saskatchewan's lead on this initiative, and thank him for his efforts in making today a reality and our participation in it a reality as well. I'd like to then talk a little bit about innovation from the perspective, I'm just trying to find the this is it here? Okay. I just wanted to talk a little bit about my presentation in the context of where I'm coming from. Although, as Curtis has said, I'm the CEO of Innovation Saskatchewan, my experience today is more from a private sector perspective. I want to talk about the realities of how do you create the challenges. In a lot of ways, there's a lot of overlap and synergy with some of the other speakers. The company that I worked for, Bioregional Food and Science, was a Saskatchewan homegrown company that has achieved a fair amount of success in its period of time. And I was one of the early executives in that group who helped grow the company from a group of about five people to a company now that has over 100 million in sales and is on four continents. So it was a success story, but like we heard from Wayne, and we heard from Peter, the challenges of growing a company in Saskatchewan are many. And I see Jim Finnegan in the audience, and I think, Jim, you can relate to this as well. So there's a lot of experience in terms of, and now I understand a lot of the things that we were doing actually have a Japanese name. So I was quite pleased to learn of that today. And the reality is that we were employees in a company that was founded by an MBA Harvard grad who called on a bunch of local Saskatchewan boys to help them grow this company. And it was just good old Saskatchewan innovation and the culture that we brought as being homegrown boys from Saskatchewan that I think actually helped to the success, because it was all about he brought an access to the market, which is something, again, in Saskatchewan we don't often have, and that's what he brought, but we brought the know-how and the creativity and the innovation that made the company a success. So the question that often people ask is why does innovation matter? And I have several references here which show that there's substantial literature that suggests innovation is very closely associated with a company's performance. Companies that are highly innovative, are their performance is equal to that, and their profitability, the longevity is also there. So these are some of the things that emphasize the importance of it. And at the bottom, it's tied to profits. Innovation excellence can boost EBIT. We used to use EBITDA as our performance metric, but EBIT by 4%. So it is tied to economic performance. So one of the things that we did at Innovation Saskatchewan was we said, we want to know if we're going to have programs, if we're going to implement activities that are going to support the innovation and the innovative capacity of Saskatchewan companies, we need to know where we are today. How do we compare against the best in the world? Where are innovation strengths and where are our weaknesses? And if you look at here, innovation is closely associated with top-line growth. And how do you grow top-line growth? Well, it's through the creation of new products and services. Market penetration and growth is done through that. And it's also on the bottom line, cost reduction. So our definition of innovation that we use at Innovation Saskatchewan is the application of new knowledge or old knowledge or existing knowledge in a new way that creates value. And the value is created by new products or new processes or new services. So just where we're clear, because right these days, innovation is probably one of the most overused words in the world. And everybody uses innovation in their taglines and their corporate visions and their strategy. So one of the things we've learned early on in our days at Innovation Saskatchewan is we better be clear on how we're defining it so that there's no misunderstanding. And one of the things we did is we contracted Brooke Dobney, who is a professor at the University of Saskatchewan School of Business, and he conducted a study. It turns out Brooke is perhaps one of the world's leading experts in innovation metrics, and he has 15 peer-reviewed publications in this area. And he has created a company called Stratagen that has identified 12 metrics, 12 drivers of innovation, and he's also developed a tool to apply those metrics to a series of organizations or a jurisdiction to get a score. And he did a study with the F1000 companies in the United States, and we had him, we thought, well, what a great benchmark for us. Let's see how we do relative to F1000 companies. How do Saskatchewan companies do? And the result was, and we just released this recently, was that we scored 1 percentage point higher than the average score of F1000. And in Saskatchewan, we had over 375 companies and organizations participate. So maybe to many of us, that won't come as a surprise, because when you think about the innovation that occurs in companies like Seedhawk, and I saw it on the farm growing up, we needed something, we couldn't buy it, we made it. And my dad spent many hours inventing a drill press and any other piece of equipment he needed to help with his farming operations. And so that's the kind of thing that has permeated. And you look at that area outside Humboldt is just loaded with all these companies that are started off as innovative farmers. So maybe for most of us in Saskatchewan, that doesn't come as a surprise. But one of the things it did identify was that there are three areas in these companies that were included in the survey where we could, if we improve on those areas, we could be in the world's leading categories of innovation, one of the leading jurisdictions. And right now we're trailing a little bit behind the world's leading jurisdictions like Sweden, Switzerland, and Finland, but we're awful close. And so one of our objectives at Innovation Saskatchewan is to work with the Chamber and other organizations, other industry associations, to find a way to improve upon those areas that would help us put us in the front group. And there are three things that I want to talk to, and I'm going to give you some examples, real-life examples from my business experience in how we address some of these things. So the first thing that was uncovered in Brooke's report is that there is a lack of an innovation strategy that is communicated to employees. That's number one. one thing where Saskatchewan companies didn't score as high as they could have. Another area is that there are inadequate processes and governance to move innovation forward. It was more serendipitous or more ad hoc than it should be or could be if it's going to compete with the likes of Finland or Sweden. And there was often a misalignment between performance measures and management systems. So how can you reward innovation in your company? Is there a formal way to do that? So I want to talk a little bit. So my experiences and my suggestions for toolkits, these are all practical things that we encountered that we had to deal with as a growing company. And I want to give you a little bit of the context. So the company that I'm going to be using my example from primarily are from a natural health products company. And we sold globally, as I said. Currently, the company is now in four continents. The market for natural health products is very much innovation-driven. I think the only sector that has shorter product life cycles is the computer science and the information technology sector. It was constantly a game of one-upmanship. And it was also vertically integrated. So we basically took raw materials, crops grown in Saskatchewan, and sold them to an end market through a branded company or a distributor. And we also had the same challenge that Peter has had in terms of finding experienced staff. The number of companies in Saskatchewan that were GMP certified for pharmaceutical production, there wasn't any, at least not when I joined Bioriginal. And that's where we needed to be. We needed to get our GMP certification as a drug manufacturer. There wasn't a GMP system in place for natural health products at that time. So we had to achieve a standard that was higher than actually what we needed, but the regulatory system didn't have one that was appropriate. We grew the sales tenfold in 7 years. And we went from, in the early 90s, the ABEX winner of the new venture in 1993 or 94, I don't remember the exact year, and less than 10 years later, we were the ABEX business of the year, full stop, competing with any of the largest companies in Saskatchewan. That is a metric we use for our progress and our growth and our success. And we're also giving Steve and the ABEX awards a plug while we're doing that. The other challenges we faced were margins were shrinking. In the early days, some of the new products we sold in borage oil was one of our first products. We enjoyed really great margins. Just as long as we could grow the crop and process it and put it in a bottle, we'd make 45 or 50 points on the product. And over that period of time of growth, those margins were less than half of that. So that was also a challenge. The other challenge we had was, how do we address this issue of being in a market that was not necessarily well regulated? And there was a lot of credibility issues. There were people out there selling a lot of snake oil in the dietary supplement market, people promising huge weight losses and miraculous cures to arthritis and heart disease. And we had to deal with that. How do we position ourselves in a market of charlatans? So when we looked at this, and again, this all came out of more or less reacting to the reality of our market and our situation here in Saskatchewan, we didn't have an innovation strategy. We probably didn't even use the word innovation. We didn't know what lean was. We thought lean was something that city workers did against their shovels. So we had no knowledge of what that was. We were basically responding to some of the challenges and the issues of rapid growth in a Saskatchewan-based company. But when we look back on this, we say, here are the different things that our innovation strategy actually included. It included a new product development plan. It included continuous improvement or cost reduction. Our motto was, we have to be low cost. That's job one. An IP strategy, we had tried to capture value that would be sustainable in a rapidly changing market where products' life cycles were very short and the value and the margins shrunk rapidly.